Valproic acid or valproate, which is known as Depakote or other names, it is a very effective medication for treating seizures, and it is worldwide available. It has a potential to prevent headaches, and it's an excellent mood stabilizer. It is cheap, and it treats adults and pediatrics and children. So it is an excellent medication. However, it has lots of side effects.
In 1963, a scientist was testing multiple compounds for anti-seizure properties to treat epilepsy. And then all of a sudden, all of these different compounds started to have anti-seizure properties, which they did not have before. So they investigated this and found that all of those compounds were solved with one common solvent, which was valproic acid. So valproic acid was actually an organic solvent that was used a lot in chemistry and organic chemistry because it's an inert solvent. That means it does not interact with other compounds. And it was actually made in 1882 and was made from valerian plant, which is natural. And then after that, they discovered that it has lots of anti-seizure potential, and then came out valproic acid as an anti-seizure drug. What a coincidence.
60 years later, valproic acid, or valproate, which I will call it from now on, is still one of the most common drugs used for epilepsy and treats other conditions. We have a love-hate relationship with this medication, because this medicine is very effective in controlling seizures. However, it comes at a great cost of lots of side effects. So everyone can experience weight gain. And most importantly, it is not safe in pregnancy and can cause lots of malformations. So let's talk about this medication in details. I am Dr. Omar Danoun, an epilepsy specialized neurologist. I will discuss how valproate works, what are the conditions that are used for, what are the side effects, how to dose this medicine, and is it safe in pregnancy and breastfeeding, and what are the things to do if this medicine is not working. And at the end, I will give you the best scenarios for this medicine to work for. First question, what types of epilepsy valproate treats? We know that valproate is considered a broad spectrum anti-seizure drugs, which means it can treat all types of seizures, including focal seizures, generalized seizures, and absent seizures. It's also used to treat status epilepticus, which is given IV to treat this state of seizures when they start and never stop. It is used for adults, and it is used for children 2 to 3 years and older, because younger than that, it can have effects on the liver. What other conditions are treated by valproate? We know, like any other anti-seizure medications or brain medications, they can work on multiple other conditions. It can treat and prevent migraine headaches, which is called migraine headache prophylaxis. It is an excellent mood stabilizer, and it is given for manic bipolar disorder or bipolar disorder 1. It is also used to treat status migraine. This case, when the headache starts and never stops and can linger for a long time. And the secret here is that you have to give it IV push over 20 minutes and not over like hour or two. And that's the only way it can help to control the headache. How does valproate work? Well, valproate works on multiple different mechanisms and locations in the brain and the cells. So it can stop the electricity from going too fast in the brain by blocking the sodium channels. Also, it can increase the inhibition in the brain by increasing the GABA in the brain. And it also can block the calcium channels, especially the T-type calcium channels. And this is an excellent mechanism for treating absent seizures. And remember, absent seizures come from the thalamus and the brain. So remember the T-type calcium channel, T is from the thalamus. How to dose valproate? Well, valproate comes in so many different formulations. It comes as capsules, it comes as sprinkles, it comes as syrup, and it comes as IV formulation, which gives it a great flexibility for use. Usually, we start at a dose of 10 to 15 milligram per kilogram per day, usually in 2 divided doses, and then increase by 5 to 10 milligram per kilogram per day over a week or 2. And then we guide the treatment by measuring blood levels of the valproate. And the most important thing when we measure the blood levels is that we have to get trough levels, which means that the lowest levels in the blood. And the best way to do that is to get the levels right before taking the next dose. Maybe I tell my patient, just take it in the morning at 8 o'clock before you take your morning pill. And we should know that valproate does interact with other medications and decreases the metabolism. So it stops the liver enzymes from processing other medications such as lamotrigine. So we should be aware of all of these interactions. If this video is of value to you, please hit the like button so that it can spread to more people. What to do if valproate is not working for me? Well, there are many reasons why any seizure medication is not working. The most common is non-compliance, which means if you miss any dose of the medication, it can be enough to trigger seizures. So you should take the medicine every single day without missing any dose. And the second thing can be that you're not taking enough of the medication, which means that the dose you're taking is not high enough. So you have to push it high to get the treatment benefit. And the third thing can be that you are not giving the medicine enough time, which means that you're giving up too early on the medication. Usually we give it about 3 to 6 months to be judged effectively. And the last thing is that you might be one of the 25% of the people who have drug-resistant epilepsy, and this type of seizures will not respond to any seizure medications at that when we use other types of treatments such as ketogenic diet or surgical treatment, which we will be talking about in the future videos. What are the side effects of valproate? We have lots of things, so let's start. So valproate is a great medication for seizures, for bipolar disorder, and for headache, but it has lots of side effects. Common side effects are nausea, vomiting, GI upset, hair loss, easy bruising, and tremors. Especially in cases who have essential tremors from before, it can get worse. It can cause weight gain, which gains a lot of weight, and it also can be toxic to the liver. So if you have any issues with the liver, you should avoid taking Depakote. It can cause thrombocytopenia, which means low platelets, and this side effect especially, the surgeons hate the most because that will increase the bleeding if there is any operations. In one syndrome, which is called Polgi syndrome, there is defect in the metabolism and the mitochondrial function. In this case, if children take this medication with the Polgi syndrome, they can have constant vomiting and liver toxicity. So these are all the common side effects, and there are a lot more uncommon or rare side effects. So that's why we have to be aware and monitor the blood counts, platelet counts, liver function, and medication levels. Can I drink alcohol and drive with valproate? Well, you should always avoid drinking alcohol along with valproate because it has combined liver toxicity. And the other thing is that valproate at the beginning, it can be sedative. So you should avoid driving right at the beginning of taking the medication and give it a little bit of time until your body can get used to it. Will valproate help me sleep? In some cases, yes, it can help you sleep and be dizzy and sleepy. And in other cases, it can disturb sleep and even cause weird dreams, especially in children. How to stop valproate if it is not working for me? If valproate needs to be stopped, it should not be stopped suddenly like any other seizure medication, and it should be tapered over a few weeks to make sure that we don't have rebound seizures. And the only time we stop it suddenly when we have severe side effects like liver toxicity or other issues that needs to be stopped urgently. Is valproate safe in pregnancy? No, valproate is not safe in pregnancy and should be avoided at any cost unless it is the last resort for seizure control and it's the only medication that works for you when you are pregnant. And it should not be used at all in any patient who has headache and it is being treated in headache with valproate. The risk of malformation is very high and it can reach an average of 14%, which is the highest among all the other anti-seizure medications. And also it can cause cognitive issues. It can decrease the IQ in the baby. It can cause autism and ADHD in the children. So it is very important to avoid valproate in any woman of childbearing age. Now, since we understand all the characteristics of valproate, what are the best cases we can use this medicine for? The best cases for this are men that have generalized epilepsy, especially juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. Works great for those myoclonic jitters and those generalized tonic-clonic seizures. And it can work great for people who have epilepsy along with other psychiatric conditions such as bipolar disorder or depression. It works for both conditions at the same time. We should definitely avoid taking or giving valproate in any woman of childbearing age because of the potential side effects and effects on the baby. And if they tell you that they're not getting pregnant, pregnancy can happen unplanned all the time. And to learn more about other anti-seizure medications and choosing the best seizure medication for the type of epilepsy, you can see this video and stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.